Welcome. This video covers user-defined route settings, or UDR, for Azure Databricks, required to ensure that network traffic is routed correctly for your workspace. Let's start by creating an Azure Databricks workspace using an ARM template. Settings that you want to call out are public IP disable, set to true. This setting means that Azure Databricks cluster will not have public IP addresses. This template would create two subnets used by Azure Databricks Workspace. One, a container subnet called the private subnet, and two, a host subnet called the public subnet. Click Review plus Create. Once validation is passed, click on Create. Your Azure Databricks Workspace has now been created with a virtual network and network security group assigned to the virtual network. Click on the Workspace link ADB-Westis2 to view the virtual network configured. Click the link under Virtual Network to go to the VNet. VNet has two subnets, private subnet and public subnet. Typical secure Azure Databricks workspace setup would have a firewall intercepting all the requests. Now let's go through the steps for creating Azure Firewall. Make sure to select the same resource group as part of your Azure Databricks workspace. Create a subnet named Azure Firewall Subnet. Create a public IP address. Note the public IP address. In this case, it's 20.236.61.152. Now, let's update the VNet and the public IP address parameter to create a firewall. The next step is to create a route table. Note the IP address assigned to the firewall. This is used to route the traffic from the subnets to the firewall's IP address. A route table will be assigned to a subnet. The subnet will be our source. We need all the traffic originating from the subnet to be routed to the firewall that we just created. Create a user-defined route using the route table to set that up. Create a user-defined route table called Route to Firewall. Select IP addresses under address prefix. Specify source IP address as 0.0.0.0/0. Set next hop type to virtual appliance and next hop address to IP of the firewall. Here's an explanation of what we just did. When we set source IP address to 0.0.0.0/0, this routes all the traffic from all the IP addresses currently assigned to that interface to a virtual appliance listening on IP address. This way, all the traffic from the source subnet will go through the Azure firewall. Associate the route table to subnet that enable public access. In this case, it's public subnet. Launch the workspace, try to create a cluster, and the cluster creation will fail with error, cluster terminated, reason, storage download failure. This occurs because we have blocked access to the storage and the VMs failed to download artifacts from storage. There are two ways to bypass the Azure firewall. The first option is to enable service endpoints that provide secure and direct connectivity to all Azure service. Second option is to create a route. A way to have more granular control is to set up a user-defined route for every type of outbound connection from the VNet. We created this workspace in West US2. Let's see if the workspace is configured to have a private IP. We can confirm this from the workspace overview. Enable No Public IP Property is set to Yes. Let's start configuring the UDRs by clicking on Routes under the Route Table Settings tab. In the public documentation on user-defined settings for Azure Databricks, refer to the section under West US2. First route to be configured in Web App, IP address for Web App in West US2 region is 40.118.174.242/32. Next, extend infrastructure 13.91.84.96/28. With secure cluster connectivity enabled, customer virtual networks have no open ports and Databricks runtime cluster nodes have no public IP addresses. Secure cluster connectivity is also known as no public IP, NPIP. When we set up this workspace, public IP was disabled, which translates as Secure Cluster Connectivity, SCC, enabled. If SCC is enabled for the workspace, you need a UDR to allow the clusters to connect to the secure cluster connectivity relay in the control plane. However, SSC relay has an FQDN. Use NSLOOKUP to look up IP address for tunnel.westis.azuredatabricks.net, and the IP is 40.86.167.110. As demonstrated, go through the configured routes for all the URLs mentioned under West US2. If the IP address is not provided, use the NSLOOKUP command line to look up the IP address that corresponds to the FQDN. If you're planning to stream using Event Hub, you can also include prod-westis-observability-event-hubs.servicebus.windows.net. Now that we have the route table in place, the next step is to start creating the cluster. Click on Start for the cluster that failed earlier before adding the routes. Despite configuring the VNet to route all traffic to Azure Firewall, using UDRs, we created additional rules that controlled the traffic flow to reach a specific IP address. So the VMs in the subnets have access to artifacts required to create this cluster successfully. Thanks for your efforts. We hope the information in this video has been helpful to you.